Hello everyone, my name is Paulo Alves, and on this video we are going to create a form validation message component for our real app using Ionic Framework. So subscribe to the channel in case you want to follow this development, and let's go to the code. On the previous video, we created the form of our login page, and also we created the error message for that form. The problem is that the code we ended up creating is being repeated 3 times only in the login screen, and probably it will be repeated many more times on other screen. So the idea here is to create a component to take care of this for us. So let's make this code better. The code that's being repeated is this one. We have a label with a red color, then we check if the form field was touched and also if there is an error in that form field. If those two conditions happen, we show an error message. It is already very clear that this code will be used on other parts of our code, so let's create an error message component for our forms. To do that, we are going to create a new command line and inform the Ionic CLI to generate a component that will be created in the components path, and the name of that component will be error message. We can see that 4 new files have been created, so let's open the HTML file, the action file, and the tests file of our component. Here in the HTML file, I'm going to create an ion label that will have the color danger. So this will simulate that component that is being repeated. Inside of it, I'll put the text error message. By looking at this, we can identify that our component should receive an input parameter, which is the error message that our component should show. Then I'll go to the action file and I'll inform that this component receives an input. Now let's go back to the HTML and use the parameter that we just created. To do that, we use the braces and the name of the parameter that we created in the component. So let's save everything and start using that component in our login page, so we can start adding the necessary changes to it. But before that, I have to declare in my login module that this new component is being used. Now I can go to the HTML file of the login page and use our error message component. I'll declare that I'm using that error message component, that its message will be email is required, and after that I can simply copy and paste this ngif, and our new component can replace this line, so I can just remove it. I'll save it, and we can see on the login screen that everything behaves in the same way as before. However, going back to our HTML file, we can clearly notice that this code using the component is not much better than the code which I used before. If I compare these two lines, we don't see much difference, right? This code would be much better if we could place those ngif instructions within our component, because they keep being repeated in the code. So that's what we are going to do now. I'll go back to my HTML file of the new component, and what I need to do is to add something very similar to that ngif instruction, but instead of adding that line, which is kind of long, what I'm going to do here is to pass a function to this ngif asking if it should show the component. This function does not exist yet, so let's go to the code of our component to declare that this function now exists, and for now I will just return false. I'll save it, and from there we will create the test for that function. Let me remove first this unnecessary code that already comes with the test. Let's create a test that should show an error message when the field is touched and the error is present. From the beginning, I will already expect that the function of our component will return true. Obviously, this test will fail, then let's work to make it pass. In order to be able to make that test pass, I need first to have access to this field, so I managed to do something like this thing being shown on the login screen. So let's go back to our component, and I'll create a new input parameter here. We'll have the name field, and it's going to be of the type form group, which is exactly the type of this element inside of the form. Now, after saving it, I can already use this element on our test. What I'm going to do is to initialize the field parameter of our component with a new form group. This form group will receive as an input an email field that is of the type new form control. With this, I am simulating exactly what's going to happen with our error message component, as it will receive a value similar to that one in the field parameter. Our test expects that this form field has been touched, so to do this, I'm going to declare that field parameter will be marked as touched. Our test also expects that an error exists in our form, so for that, I will add an error to the field. The error I'm going to add is the required error as true, I mean, the mandatory error. By doing this, I'm simulating exactly this part from our login screen. Notice that I saved it and the test keeps failing. So now we have to modify that function to make it pass, right? Meanwhile, I'm going to copy this code from the login page only so we can base our new code on it. I'll copy to the error component and now we can already use this as an example to facilitate our work. So let's code that. If the field of the component was touched and also that field has an error of the type required, then I will return true, otherwise I will return false. After saving it, we'll see that our test now passed. Now, let's go back to our login screen and modify the component of our login page so that it receives this field parameter as an input with the name field. To do that, I can simply remove this part of the code, and now instead of an ngif, I'm passing the field as an input. I'll save it, and if we go to the login page, we'll see that the component is behaving exactly the way it was before. The field is now required. If I put a value on it, it becomes invalid. But if we look at the code on our login page and the code of our component, we see a problem. On the login page, I inform in one place that the error is mandatory, but just below, I inform that the error is an invalid email. However, in the component's code, I'm just checking if the error is mandatory. Then, let's create a new test to adjust our code. It should show an error message on field touched and email error present. So now let's create the body of our test. As these two tests are very similar, I will simply copy and paste this. Now the change I will do is that the email error is present, not the mandatory error. After running the test, we will see that it fails. Then let's adjust the code of our component for that test to pass. What our component needs to receive for it to know whether or not to show the error component is the kind of error it has to check. For mandatory error, our component should know that it has to test the required. For an email error, it should know that it has to test the email error. So let's add a new input field to our component, which will be called error, and it is of the type string. Because by it being a string, I can just send whatever I want. With that, I can use this generic input field instead of this specific error that we have. I can change required to this.error. I'll save it and now you'll notice that our tests are failing. This is because we didn't add this error input field. So let's fix those tests. On this component, for the field error, I have to pass the error required. On that second test, to the component error input field, I have to pass email as the error type. After saving it, now yeah, we are going to see all of our tests are passing. But what's happening now is that these two tests are redundant. I mean, they are testing exactly the same thing. What they are testing is if, when the field has an error, the component is shown. So let's redo those tests. I can already remove that second test as they are doing the same thing. And to make the first test more generic, I'm going to change some things here. I'm going to change that error in the input field to any error. So now I'm making it clear in my code that it works for any kind of error. To make it clear also that the test is for any type of field, I will put any field here. And to finish this, I will remove this required and I will add also any error. After saving it, we'll see that our test passed. Now I have to test the other cases. I'll test that the code should hide the error message when the field has not been touched. I'll copy the code from our previous test, I'll paste it here, and I'll remove the instruction that the field has been touched. After saving it, we'll obviously see that this test will fail because I'm expecting that the component should be shown, but as it was not touched, it should not be shown. Then here, instead of true, I should expect false. Okay, another case that we should test is the possibility that the field has been touched, but there is no error on that field. Then for the title, I'll put that it should hide the error message when the field has been touched, but there are no errors. Let's copy the code from the first test again, because now we have a variation from that test. Then we can make our lives easier. I will leave the instruction that it was touched, but I will remove the instruction to add an error to that field. After saving it, again, our test will fail because we are expecting that the component should be shown. However, as there is no error in that component, then it should not be shown. It should be hidden. Then I can expect that this function is going to return false. After saving it, we'll see that our test now will pass. There is one more test case that we should check. I'll test that I should hide the error message when the field has been touched and there is an error, but the error I want to show is an error that is different from the error the component shows. As an example, for our email field on the login screen, we have two errors, one as the type required and one as the type invalid email. What I will test here is that the mandatory message should not show up when the email validation error happens. So let's copy the code of our first test and place it here to make it easier. I'll inform that the error that this component is expecting to show is another error, not this any error here that the component has. After saving it, we'll see that our test will fail. And that happens because our component really shouldn't show the error message. So if I change it from true to false, we'll see that our test will pass. Now we can go back to our login page and modify our error component so it works the way it should work. Here I should inform the error to show is the required error. Now what I can do is to duplicate the line and check if the email is invalid. Then I can change from required to email. After that, I can remove this line also. Let's do something similar for the password field. Since the password field is required, I'll copy the required part. I will change it from email to password. Also, on the item, I'll change from email to password, and the error should be required. So I already can remove this line. So let's save it, go to the login page, and verify that everything is behaving the same way as before. If I touch the email, the mandatory message shows up. If I type something in the email, the mandatory message disappears and the invalid message shows up. If I put a valid email, the invalid email message disappears. And if I type a value in the password field, the mandatory message disappears. And great, now we already have a component that certainly will be reused in several parts of our code. On the next video of this application using the Ionic Framework, we'll move on to the state management part of our app using the idea of Redux. So hit the like button if you enjoyed this video, subscribe to the channel in case you want to follow the development of this real app using Ionic Framework, share it with your dev friends, and see you on the next video.